Why is it that we have to have eye contact when we are talking to someone? Does it really add to the speech intelligibility? Well, you can sense the mood and more of the meaning of the conversation if you have eye contact, but the acoustics of the voice is also a very important factor. The level of the speech is much higher in front of a person, but the intelligibility is also much higher. This is due to the content of the frequencies in front of the person talking as opposed to behind the person. In this diagram, we see the blue line representing the high frequencies and the red line representing the lows. The green line are the mids. High frequencies are only radiated in front of the person. And these high frequencies add to the speech intelligibility, and without them, we compromise the meaning of the message. If we look at the vertical plane, we will also see a difference in the frequencies. There is a higher representation of the high mids in the 2 to 4 kHz area above the head. And this is very important to know, that this is where all the consonants are. In the following, we will hear the differences between the positions on a female singer. We use a common reference at 1 meter as our normal, because 1 meter is the normal distance for a conversation between two people. So compared to the reference 1 meter away, a placement on the forehead is close to identical. The forehead position sounds like this.
I used to feel so uninspired.
If we move the microphone backwards, to the position just in front of the ear, we see that we then lose a lot of the high frequencies. It sounds like this.
I used to feel so uninspired.
Next position is the headset position. It's not as far behind the mouth as the ear position, so the high mids in the 2 to 3 kHz range are not as attenuated as before.
I used to feel so uninspired.
There's a bit more of the mid-range, where the consonants are predominant, so there are many good reasons to use the headset position, but it is still lacking a bit of the speech intelligibility compared to the forehead position. The next position is the typical lavalier position on the chest, which introduces a few challenges. One challenge is that the level of the direct sound of the voice is much lower than on the headset position, and we therefore pick up much more background noise. And frequency-wise, we lose not only the high frequencies, but much more in the mid-range, again, compromising the speech intelligibility.
I used to feel so uninspired.
And again, hear all four positions without me interrupting in between.
I used to feel so uninspired. I used to feel so uninspired. I used to feel so uninspired. I used to feel so uninspired.
So, in order to preserve the natural sound of the voice when you are forced to place the microphone in a less than optimal position, like on the chest, you have to compensate with an EQ. You can use these basic graphs for inspiration to compensation. But this will only work for you if you are working with a microphone with a frequency response you already know. If you don't know the frequency response of the microphone you're working with and you follow these common rules, there is a huge risk that you're doing more damage than good for the sound. Microphones with a high degree of consistency might be a little more expensive, but it pays off tenfold in post-production.